Doctor, did you ever see the thing?
The Carpenter Kurt Russell thing or the Howard Hawks thingy with the walking carrot?
Not sure I see your point, anyway.
You brought me back. They'll get us all!
I give you my word, I'll protect you. Whatever happened here, I can help, I promise.
How? They got everybody, they changed them!
Into what?
Like robots. Slaves. Cyber slaves.
Cyber slaves?
Amy, get out of the way!
What was that?
A cyber mat.
It's not anything like a mouse mat. It didn't look like one.
Weird. I've seen them kill people before, but never turn people into robots. That's new. That's fascinating. Why would they do that? Let me take a look.
No! Get away! Get away from me! And get out of here.
You have to let me help you.
It's too late for me now.
What's going on here?
I think the answer to that is in there.
Yeah, of course. It would be.
Knock, knock. Oh, hello. And who are you then? Conversation not your strong point, is it? Amy, I'll keep his attention while you think of a way to overpower
him. I thought that was your job.
I thought you liked to be independent. Now, if you could think of something, fast! Well done, Amy. Let's see if we can learn a bit more about this fellow. This keycard says it belongs to Alan Watts. I imagine that's who he used to be.
Used to be?
The Cybermat nanoforms have done their work. Nothing really left of Alan here. Poor chap.
Watch out, Amy. There's another cyber slave around the corner.
Oh, this place gives me the creeps.
Until we know exactly what's going on, we need to watch our step. Look, a tin can on legs. Meet my can opener.
It did not like that.
The sonic signal gives them a cyber migraine. The sonic's frequency keeps them at bay. We might be able to rig something at another frequency to stun or deactivate them.
That would be good. Those things are worse than spiders.
Spiders? I'd rather we change the subject. Let's see if we can get some information out of this system.
We better be cautious here.
Doctor, look out!
It don't get many visitors up here, do you?
I thought you were one of them. Who are you?
This is Amy and I'm the doctor. We answered your distress beacon.
Thank God. My name's Elizabeth Meadows. I've been barricaded in here for days.
It's all right. The doctor will be able to help. What happened to your arm?
I fell and hurt it running away from those things. They're everywhere.
You mean the Cybermats?
They bite. Inject a nanovirus that converts flesh and bone into living machinery.
Cyber slaves? But slaves to who?
To the Cybermen, of course. Where did you find this?
We're a geological survey. It must have been under the ice for 10,000 years.
Amazing.
So who are the Cybermen?
Cybernetic bodies with living brains. Brains surgically removed from those they conquer. Stripped of everything but the urge to kill and convert more like themselves.
And they've been under the ice 10,000 years.
Apparently. And the Cybermats have been converting a small army of slaves to dig them out. Is that right, Professor?
Yes. I've been trying to develop an antidote. Something that will reverse the nanovirus. Make my team human again.
You're very good. But it won't work. We need a sample of the virus in its pure form.
You stay here, Professor, and do what you can. Amy, we're going to catch ourselves a Cybermat. There's a handheld distress beacon here. That'll do nicely.
I thought you were more into answering SOS calls, not making them.
This is just what we need to deal with the Cybermats.
Clarification request.
If I can get it to emit the same frequency pulse as the sonic screwdriver, but stronger, it will work like an EMP device and disable them all.
Sounds like a plan to me.